Well, my friends, we are celebrating Country Music Month in October with our guest, Tom T. Hall. Tom, welcome back to our show.
Thank you, Ralph. And you know, I record for Mercury Records, and they said it's also Tom T. Hall Month. Isn't that nice?
Is October Tom T. Hall Month?
Came right along the same time as Country Music Month.
My, how did that happen?
Tickled me to death.
Does that mean there are big displays of Tom T. Hall records all around? Or, I can't talk. All around the country?
Yes, right. Just trying to sell some records. I appreciate it.
Well, that's a nice tribute to you.
Sure it is.
And did I mention that Bayer Aspirin is one of our sponsors?
Yes, and Music City News.
And Beats Not Chewing Tobacco.
Right.
And your local
True Value Hardware.
That's correct.
And there's one in my neighborhood, by the way.
Is there?
Yes,
there is. You be sure and go by tomorrow.
Oh, I do.
Here's Jeannie Shepherd to open the show.
Marshall Dillon, Kojak, and apple pie. I believe in chicken on Sunday, extra crispy and southern fried. I may be just a little old-fashioned, but I believe in heaven above. And when it comes to a man and a woman, I'm a believer in a whole lot of loving, and it's your sweet loving I'm thinking of. I don't think there's such a thing as too much of a good thing, and that's why I believe in a whole lot of love. I believe in country living, helping your neighbor and wearing a smile. I believe in Sunday preaching and banjo picking, bluegrass style. I believe in being faithful. I believe in honesty. I believe we were meant for each other, and I believe you. In a whole lot of loving, and it's your sweet loving I'm thinking of. I don't think there's such a thing as too much of a good thing, and that's why I believe in a whole lot of love. Yeah, I'm a believer in a whole lot of loving, and it's your sweet loving I'm thinking of. I don't think there's such a thing.
Hey, I just thought of this. You know who's a hardware freak? He used to be. Sonny James.
I am.
How are you? Just loves to go in and look.
I do, too. Just find something somebody's invented. And I bet you a dollar that you have, too.
What? We're on the air, Tom.
Oh, we are?
Yes. You got to lean in and talk.
Oh, I see. I didn't know we were on the air. I told you about that the other day. I love to go to hardware stores and see things that they've invented. And
are we really on the air?
Yes, we are.
Okay.
You've heard Jeannie Shepherd open our show with I'm a Believer.
All right.
Wasn't that a terrific lecture? Oh, yeah. I'm Thelma Winter.
Oh, Sims, Dr. Sims.
Doctor? Uh-huh. Oh, say, I've got this headache.
Oh, Thelma,
luckily, I had a couple of Bayer with me. Bayer aspirin works fast. I mean, nothing's faster. Uh-huh. But now you're the doctor. What would you recommend?
Probably Plato.
Plato. what kind of a doctor?
I'm a doctor of philosophy.
Philosophy. You could get in trouble giving out medical advice.
Get Bayer aspirin. Use only as directed.
If I want to find out where the country music stars are performing, I pick up my copy of Music City News. This great country music paper has all the news of country music, plus feature stories and never-before-published pictures of your favorite stars. Start your subscription now. To subscribe, simply put your check or money order for $7 in an envelope and mail it to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's $7 to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. Well, Tom, we have done away with the subject of Bobby Bear on this show, and I probably won't come back to that, but we keep coming back to the subject of Kentucky. Now we are in the western part of the state.
Right. And I was riding through there one day on my bus, the new one, not the one that I got from George Jones, and he sold it to Loretta and all that. But I was driving through Kentucky, and Alan Pace, my piano player, we were driving a bus. He said, "Looks like rain up ahead." I said, "It never rains in Paducah." And we got there, and just as we got to the city limits, it started raining, and we drove through Paducah, and it quit. So I got my guitar and started writing a song. Called it Rain in Every Town Except Paducah, and then one day it rained in Paducah, too.
And didn't you receive some kind of award for this?
Yes, the mayor and some folks up there gave me a Duke of Paducah Award, which simply means that I had done something nice for Paducah, and they thought I was a good fellow.
Do you have some sort of scroll or plaque?
Right. It's a little certificate framed, and if you do something nice for Paducah, which you are doing by playing this record, they'll probably make you a Duke of Paducah.
Oh, I see. I remember, and I'm going to interrupt this train of thought we have going about Paducah. I remember another Tom T. Hall quote. At Talladega, Alabama, one night, when you said, "It never rains on the Tom T. Hall show," right before it started raining.
That's right. We went a whole fair season, and it never rained. And somebody asked me, I said, "Never rained on the Tom T. Hall show." And then we went through a whole year where it rained everywhere we went. So next year is a dry season.
All right. This is out of your latest album, isn't it?
Right. I wrote a song about it.
Worked construction for a while in St. Louis. I was helping build a great big new motel. It rained so much I couldn't make the payments. I sold my car, it didn't run too well. Got a job at making stovepipes in Ohio. But it rained so much, I moved along again. It never seemed to rain when you were with me. Or I just didn't notice rain back then. Oh, it rained in every town except Paducah. In a way it reminds me of you. It rained in every town except Paducah. Then one day it rained in Paducah too. Got a job at stringing wire down in Atlanta. Didn't rain too much, but there's a constant mist. I read two books and learned to play canasta. Till I got bored and I gave it up for this. I rode that scream machine out at the fairground. I lost some weight, but then I put it back. It rained as I was walking back to Peach Street. I used to be afraid of things like that. Oh, it rained in every town except Paducah. In a way that reminds me of you. It rained in every town except Paducah. Then one day it rained in Paducah too.
Tom T. Hall, the storyteller, and that's from an album called I Wrote a Song About It, which I suppose is a natural thing for you to do. You write a song about so many situations that you personally run into, don't you?
Yes, and I was talking to Jerry Kennedy, my producer, the other day. You know, with my career, every record is almost a new career. Because instead of just getting in some sort of a bag and just doing that, we've done so many different kinds of records that I get a lot of complaint. People say, I want to hear more songs about Sneaky Snake. And other guys want to hear songs about truck driving, and some guys want to hear about old dogs. And it's really hard to keep them all happy and keep them together. And that bothers me some because I don't want to keep doing the same thing all the time. But every time I change a little bit, it makes the guy that liked the other thing I was doing kind of mad, and the other fellow over here is happy, and then the one on each side of the room, and you work in a club, and one of them wants you to be Sneaky Snake, and the other wants you to do a ballad of $40. Did I confuse you?
Well, I
could tell you the story about the bus trading again.
I think you said it earlier when you said you can't please everybody.
Well, that's right, I guess.
All right, you've heard Tom T. Hall, and it rained in every town except Paducah. Tom, you want to bring on this young fella. I credit Tom T. Hall with the creation of his success. And talking about Johnny Rodriguez.
Well, John is rich and famous now, and I'd have to say this, you know, I've not known a lot of people who just literally really kind of came up overnight, even though John had done a lot of work on his music before I met him. He hadn't changed toward me or, you know, toward his friends. Of course, he's awfully busy, and he's got an awfully big band.
I worked with John the other night, and there was 8 pieces.
That's right.
And he said he's going to add another one.
That's right, and he's going to buy another bus, and I don't know. I said, John, I said, they're going to be saying, here is the James Brown of country music. But, you know, I think the reason for that, John loves music. He loves his music, and just the more of it there is, the better he likes it, and he has a good show.
This is his newest record called Love Put a Song in My Heart.
Yes, your love put a song, put a song, put a song in my heart. Never have I heard this beautiful music before. Yes, your love put a song, put a song, put a song in my heart. A beautiful song of two people in love evermore. It wasn't too long ago, I thought I would never know. What reason has anyone to sing a happy song? I knew only loneliness, but then I found happiness. And now I just want the world to smile and sing along. Cause your love put a song, put a song, put a song in my heart. Never have I heard this beautiful music before. Yes, put a song, put a song, put a song in my heart. A beautiful song of two people in love evermore. Si, qua, morbus, una canzone in mi corazón. Never have I heard this beautiful music before. Amor, pues una canción en mi corazón. A beautiful song of two people in love evermore. Yeah, your love put a song, put a song, put a song in my heart. this beautiful music before. It's a love, but a song, but a song, but a song in my heart.
Before I leave Johnny Rodriguez, one quick story. Didn't you take him to Mercury Records and have them audition him?
Right. We went to the airport one day. My guitar came in late. You know, your guitar doesn't always fly on the same planes that you do. And my guitar came in late, and I went out to get it, and I said, hey, we got a guitar. Let's go by Mercury and see Roy Day. I said, you know, they're good friends of mine down there. They're good folks. So I didn't want to bother Jerry Kennedy because he's the big wheel down there. But I said, we're going to see Roy. And I told him, I said, you know, I've been here for like 7 years and I've never recommended anybody to make records. So we went into Roy Day's office and John took out the guitar. And, you know, Roy was thinking, oh my goodness, Tom T going to start this, bringing in, being a talent scout. So I got in there and I had asked John Rodriguez to translate I Can't Stop Loving You for me and from Spanish to English. And he would just sing it for me on the bus. So, I said, sing that song where you sing half in English and half in Spanish. And he just sang about 30 seconds. And Roy Day said, we'll sign him. I said, well, don't you have to call some big people in Chicago or New York or something? He said, no, we'll sign him. I said, there you are, John. You're a star.
Well, you've heard Little John with Love Put a Song in My Heart.
We work in the sky where the steel rose high, me and my river to lose. Look out for each other like brother for brother, and beach nuts and tobacco we chew. There's no time to daydream, crawling on a steel beam, imagine what that teaches you. There's no maybe or might, friend, it had better be right. So beach nuts and tobacco you chew. When it comes to a man's chewing tobacco, it's gotta be right. Beach nuts got that real tobacco taste you want. Rich, smooth, satisfying. Taste that stays that way all chew through. Try beach nut chewing tobacco. Once you do, you got a friend for life. Your buddy's no stranger when you're sharing the danger, and he's more than a friend to you. The chances we take don't allow for mistakes, and beach nuts the tobacco we chew.
Here's the pretty one, Crystal Gale.
No longer notice if I'm wearing perfume. I seldom hear a loving word from you. Your attention's wrapped up in the morning paper, and I feel a restless yearning for something new. We used to whisper love across the nighttime. Now we never whisper nor recall. Our love is left upon the shelf of winter, where the sunlight never touches it at all. It's a habit for us to be together. We sit and watch the deadly shadows grow. Every day last year I left for California. This is my year for Mexico. Your back is turned to me while you are reading. I close my eyes while I pretend to doze. From the road I hear the sound of passing traffic. Some of them are bound for Mexico. It's a habit for us to be together. We sit and watch the deadly shadows grow. Every day last year I left for California. This is my year for Mexico. Mm-hmm.
Crystal Gayle singing This Is My Year for Mexico. And now here are Roy Rogers and Dale Evans.
In the sweet by and by.
Isn't that beautiful? You can have that recording and 30 other inspirational gospel songs, including Ray Price singing The Old Rugged Cross, Johnny Cash, I Saw a Man, Loretta Lynn, Old Camp Meetin' Time, and 27 other beautiful songs. Now, I'd like for everybody listening to me right now to have this very special two-record album with 31 great gospel songs sung by your favorite country singers. All you need to do to get this country's gospel is send 598 to me, Ralph Emery, Box 61, 110 21st Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee. For this big two-record, 31-song album, send 598 to Ralph Emery, Box 61, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
Not a sign.
Here is the much talented Ronnie Millsap and Daydreams About Night Thing.
I'm having daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and while my hands make a living, my mind's home loving you. I'm having daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and every night you make my daydreams come true. Well, all day long while I'm working in town, time slows down to a crawl. When I'm not thinking about you, I'm checking the clock on the wall. Then it's goodbye factory and hello love, and there's a smile across my face, 'cause I'm back in the arms of your sweet love, where my thoughts have been all day. I'm having daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and while my hands make a living, my mind's home loving you. I'm having daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and every night you make my daydreams come true.
That's old Ronnie, honking on a piano and singing daydreams about night things. Ralph Emery and Tom T. Hall here, entertaining you on the radio, my friends. Tom, we're going to go back to your new album, or your latest album, which is called I Wrote a Song About It, and features you and your beautiful teeth on the cover.
Yes, it does.
And I wish you'd tell me about this song called Lion Jim.
I thought you were going to have me tell you about my teeth.
I may do that.
My dentist has that in his office. You know that, Dr. Rutherford. He's a great guy. He's an Irish fellow.
This may be unethical. You know, dentists are not allowed to advertise.
Well, I'm not going to charge him for it. If you don't. He's just a good fellow.
He is a dentist who
does work for a lot of music business person.
A lot of people in the industry get their teeth fixed by him.
Yeah.
I saw your album displayed prominently in his office.
Well, Mercury wanted a picture of me smiling, and I don't know, I look like a used car salesman or something in that picture, but that's what they want, and I do whatever they tell me.
New set of caps, huh?
Yeah.
Is that what that is?
That's right.
Tommy, you look like you have just bought yourself about $1 million worth of teeth there.
Well, they work.
Huh?
If you don't believe it, next time I do this show, you bring some rosiniers, and I say, all right. Let's see here. Like, hey, I want to sing a song about, I don't know if I did. Yeah, my uncle. I had an uncle, Jim Henderson. My mother's side of the family were the Hendersons. And his hobby was lying. I don't want to give people the impression that this was a thing he did through malice or anything. He just thought it was funny to tell big tales. And some of them are in the song. It's called Lying Jim.
Did he ever enter the National Liars Contest?
No, he was an amateur.
Oh.
Yeah, he never made professional status.
But this is about a person, right, in your family, then?
Yes, on my mother's side. And he just thought it was the greatest thing in the world. And there are some great long stories about lies that he'd tell. Like, he had a whole brick plant go back to work. They went out and bought all equipment to go back to work and everything. And it was a rumor. But his theory that people believed whatever they wanted to hear. If you tell them something they didn't want to hear, they wouldn't believe it. But if you told them something they wanted to hear, they'd believe that. So, and it worked for him. He told some great tales.
Lion Jim, one of our local brethren. Hey there, Lion Jim, come on, tell us another. Now, Lion Jim got caught one time a-stealing a bunch of chicken. The neighbors all got so upset that the law went out to get him. Jim was sitting there eating the leg, and the law said, "What have you done?" Jim said, "I was just passing that house, and these chickens followed me home." Lion Jim, one of our local brothers. Hey there, Lion Jim, come on, tell us another. Now old Lion Jim got drunk one time, he passed right out in church. Fell right off the front row pew, someone said, "Lord, he's hurt." Next morning, old Jim sobered up out on the preacher's farm. He said, "Preacher, I was wrestling the devil and that rascal broke my arm." Lion Jim, one of our local brothers. Hey there, Lion Jim, come on, tell us another. Now old Lion Jim was broke one time and he tried to borrow money. Now some thought Jim was terrible, some folks thought Jim was funny. They said, "Jim, we'll give you $5 just for one more lie." Jim said, "Boys, I ain't got time. My old rich uncle just died." Lion Jim, one of our local brothers. Hey there, Lion Jim, come on, tell us another. Now Jim was seeing a neighbor's wife, and the man came home from work. Well, old Jim grabbed his clothes to run, but he only got his shirt. But around and around that house they went, and Jim got caught in the kitchen. Jim said, "I was just showing your wife where I got bit by a kitten." Lion Jim, one of our local brothers. Hey there, Lion Jim, come on, tell us another. Jim said, "Well, I got this aunt up in Cleveland. She's a great big fat person and weighs a little over 300 pounds, or a lot over 300 pounds. And one day she was going down the interstate and saw a bus coming down the road, and it was the Atlanta Falcons. And so they were off. Well, they hadn't had anything to eat, you know, because you know how football players are. They eat a lot. So, you know, my aunt being a great big generous person, why, she said..."
That's Tom T. Hall with the story of Lion Jim. You know, Tom, you lead a pretty interesting life, and I don't know how much time you get spent at home. Show business is, or stardom in your case, has made you a very, very busy person, and yet you've got a very nice place out there where you live. You've got a pond filled with fish stocked for you. You can go out there and fish right off your dock. You ever get a chance to enjoy that?
Yes, I do. I really take... Sometimes I just take time, you know. I get away from the phone. I go to my barn where I write my songs and kind of hide out and hang out. But, you know, in the music business today, especially in country music, you can find something to do 24 hours a day if you just load up your schedule and do all the things. And I'm reluctant not to do things if it involves my music or involves my career. I'm reluctant to say, "Well, you know, I don't want to do that," because it sounds kind of like I'm a star or something, you know. So, I do most of the things people ask me, but I find a little time, and I'd like to, I don't want, I think the most terrible thing can happen is have success and have it become your downfall, your success. So I'd like, you know what success I've had? I'd like to for people to say, well, he handled it well and he enjoyed it and made something of it, other than have your success make you a colossal failure. I think that would really be a crime.
How could that happen, Tom?
Well, it's happened before to other people, where success has really been their biggest problem, really. Mm-hmm. I would like it to be my biggest blessing.
You mean because they couldn't handle it?
Right. I've seen that happen. You know that you have too, and so I want to enjoy my success and make it a positive thing instead of have it, you know.
Let's get the word out in front. Have you ever been accused of being a prima donna?
No, I haven't. No, on occasion, I've gotten a big head like everybody else. I have a hit, and people say, boy, that's really good. And, you know, if I don't catch myself for a couple of hours, I'm sitting around kind of smiling to myself. You know, I think, boy, that's good. You know?
Yeah, but isn't it, would you say it's improper to enjoy your success?
I think if you're arrogant about it, it is. I think if you take too much credit yourself, you know, if you're given a gift and then you take credit for having the gift when the gift was given to you, if songwriting or singing or making hit records or anything were something that you could achieve, there'd be thousands of people who would be in my position. But it must be a gift, and I'd rather be thankful for that and not just walk around as if I had done all this my own. It'd be silly to think that, I think.
Your point is well taken, Mr. Hall.
All right.
Miss Brenda Lee is going to sing the next song. What is it?
She may not be from Kentucky. I said that a day or so ago. But I think she went to Berea College in Kentucky.
She did?
Right.
Okay.
So maybe she didn't. I don't know. I may be all wrong. Brenda's going to call me up and say, well, okay.
If I could never see you, if I could never hold you, if I could never touch your face or feel your warm embrace, I'd still remember laughing, I'd still remember talking, I'd still remember loving a lot, just touching you. You know I've not forgotten, 'cause everything is just bringing it back. You know it's just bringing it back. A familiar face, a familiar place, just brings it all back. Everything is just bringing it back. A good song's bringing it back. And after so much time, you know everything's bringing it back. I'm thinking in my solitude, wondering about your attitude, thinking maybe that your love has died. But there it is, I can see it in your eyes, the look of sweet surrender, with a touch of too much sadness. 'Cause I hurt you so, you know your sorrow shows, you just can't stay, oh, you can't let go. 'Cause everything is just bringing it back. You know it's just bringing it back. A familiar place, a familiar face, just brings it all back. Everything is just bringing it back. A good song's bringing it back. And after so much time, you know everything's bringing it back.
That's Brenda Lee. Brenda with Bringing It Back. True Value Hardware Stores can help make the high cost of living a little easier to live with. Right now, they're featuring a selection of General Electric appliances that can earn you a $2, $3, or $5 rebate from GE. Here's how you can get $5 back from GE. Visit your nearby True Value Hardware store and ask about GE's king-size toaster oven. It toasts 4 slices of bread at once. It bakes a family-size meatloaf, even top brown sandwiches and snacks. Has convenient upfront controls, a see-through glass door, and 2 racks. Purchase of the GE king-size toaster oven earns a $5 rebate. Purchase of 25 other GE appliances earn rebates too, from $2 to $5. Ask your True Value hardware dealer how to get GE's appliance rebate, but act now. The offer is good only through October 20th. Get rebates on designated General Electric appliances. You'll find them at participating True Value hardware stores near your home.
You know, Ralph, I'm a great fan of songwriters, and here's one of Nashville's finest, Larry Gatlin, and Let's Turn the Lights On.
There are a lot of people who are living in the darkness, 'cause the world has turned their lights off, and there's mountains in the way. There are so many thirsting for a little cup of kindness, or a kindly smile from someone to brighten up their day. Let's turn the lights off, let's move the mountain, let's make a way for all of the thirsty to drink at the fountain. Let's feed the hungry, take care of the lonely, turn the lights on, move the mountain, make a way. It's easy just to sit around and never lift a finger, except to point at someone's failures every time you can. But if you've ever been so low you had to reach up to touch the bottom, you'll know by pointing fingers, don't make a helping hand. Let's turn the lights on, let's move the mountain, let's make a way for all of the thirsty to drink at the fountain. Let's feed the hungry, take care of the lonely, turn the lights on, move a mountain, make a way. Let's turn the lights on, let's move us a mountain, let's make a way for all of the thirsty to drink at the fountain. Let's feed the hungry, take care of the lonely, turn the lights on, move a mountain, make a way. Let's move us a mountain, let's make a way for all of the thirsty to drink at the fountain. Let's feed the hungry, take care of the lonely, turn the lights on, move a mountain.
All right, Larry has a super, super voice. Larry Gatlin with Let's Turn the Lights On. Tom, are you in the, speaking of songwriters, there, I know in Nashville there is a Nashville Songwriters Association.
Right.
Aren't you in their Hall of Fame?
No, I'm not in the Hall of Fame. I was named Songwriter of the Year in 72, which is probably my greatest accomplishment to date.
When you consider all the songwriters in
Absolutely.
Nashville.
Absolutely. And I am a member of the Board of Directors. I'm a member at large because I travel so much, but... I was on the board of directors for a couple of years.
I know each year they enshrine so many writers into the Hall of Fame.
Right.
That's something for you to achieve, then.
Oh, there's a lot of guys in there before me, I think.
Well, I imagine they'll put you in
there.
Well,
I hope so. It'd be a great honor.
I mean, you have written a few hits. You got any idea how many hits you've written?
No, I don't even know how many songs I've written. People keep asking me, and everybody else says 300 or 400, so that's what I say. But I wrote, when I was working with Jimmy Newman and Dave Dudley and you and Bear, and we were all down at the Key Talent Agency, I wrote 500 songs while we were all hanging around there. That's right.
Where are they, in a trunk someplace?
No, they're in New York now or someplace. But I wrote 500 songs. And then since then, I left that organization, I guess, about 3 or 4 years ago, and I'm, you know, still writing songs on it.
That was 1965.
Right. I'm going to count them up. And then when people ask me, I'll say 465 and 2 verses and a half a chorus. I'll have it right down.
Here's Ferlin Husky.
I was doing fine until I saw her yesterday. I glanced up as she went walking by. I had turned my head and looked the other way. For an old memory got in my eye. Time was slowly healing all the hurt that she caused me. I could hear her name and still not cry. But yesterday the heartaches all started once again. When an old memory got in my eye. An old memory just stepped on me and walked on by like she'd never known me. At first I thought I couldn't stop my loving her, but I've convinced myself I'd have to try. I think I might have made it in another day or so, but an old memory got in my eye. Yes, an old memory got in my eye.
One of my favorite people, Ferlin Husky, with An Old Memory Got in My Eye. I've been reading Music City News for years, and I can promise you it's the most informative country music publication there is. It sure helps me keep informed on what my country music friends are doing. I think that every listener to the Ralph Emery Show should subscribe. And now you can subscribe right through this show. To start your monthly subscription, simply send your check or money order to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's $7 to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. You'll be happy you did.
Nice party, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Hi, I'm Betty Walsh.
Bentley, Dr. Bentley.
Doctor? Uh-huh. I have this headache.
Oh, I'm not a
But I just took two Bayer. I mean, Bayer aspirin really works fast. I mean, for me, nothing's faster. Do you practice right here in the city, Doctor?
At the Philharmonic. We're doing Beethoven's Fifth.
Beethoven's Fifth. Doctor, what kind of a...
I'm a doctor of music.
Music?
Right.
You know something? You could get in big trouble giving out medical advice.
Get Bayer aspirin. Use only as directed.
I met a girl one time, and I knew her for about, I guess a year and a half. And every time I'd see her, she had the same book in her hand. And I thought it was a different story with the same cover or something. But the truth of the matter is, she read the same book day in and day out, all the time. And I wrote a song about it.
The girl from West Virginia read the same book all the time. At first I thought perhaps she wasn't settled in her mind. She'd read it front to back and then she'd read it over again. She knew that I knew she knew what happened in the end. She would go to work each morning, that's the book that she would take. She'd read it on her lunch hour, and she'd read it on her break. Her calm expression never changed from page to page to page. You know the story never changed from day to day to day. Some people said it was a book about a love affair that grew and grew throughout the years and never knew a care. A book wherein the people loved and dreams all turned out right.
They say she even took the book to bed with her at night. I recall the tattered pages and the cover faded out of a walking windblown woman by some old majestic house. One day I even asked her why she did that, and she said, "Mr. Hall, this is the best book I have ever read." Some people say it was a book about a great romance. She picked it up the night she didn't make the high school dance. Ain't it strange what life can sometimes do to people's minds? Like the girl in West Virginia reads the same book all the time.
That also is from the album I Wrote a Song About It, Tom T. Hall with The Girl Who Read the Same Book All the Time. Well, I don't know about you, Tom, but I'm going to the house, but I'll be back tomorrow.
Well, I'm going to go out and catch me a catfish in Fox Hollow, and
I'll see you tomorrow.
Tell you about it tomorrow.
Okay. Our show presented by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, Bayer Aspirin, the Music City News, and your local True Value Hardware store. This is Ralph Emery for Tom T. Hall, saying so long till tomorrow.